all blessings and love of the one truth that wherever we may go, we're always exactly where we've always been. All is always exactly where it's always been. Now, here is the big question of this video. So let's get to it. I say, do not try and process what's being said. Do not try and process it. When I say bypass the intellect, I'm saying bypass the processing of this. It's not about process, it's about permeation. Let what is being said simply be there. And the being there, let the being there-ness permeate. And of course it's going to cause consternation. Because we want to process. Listen, reality doesn't need to be processed. Reality doesn't need to be processed. Isness does not need to be processed. What we're pointing to is isness. Isness is. Reality is. Pure spaciousness is. We're never out of place in pure spaciousness. We're never out of place with pureness. Nothing is ever out of place at all. Nothing is ever out of place at all with pure spaciousness. Sri Anandamayi Ma used to say she could see God everywhere just as plainly as we see one another. Literally could see God everywhere. There's nowhere where God is not. Nothing is out of place. Nothing is out of place. So what needs to be processed? So we're practicing not processing. We're practicing relating here in a way of not processing. Isness. We're practicing it. Now, of course, that throws us into consternation. Of course. This is then why we must come in the mood of humility, mood of repentance. Humble, saying, I have a severe problem. I have a continuity problem. Very severe continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. It's the only problem there is. It's the only problem I'll ever have. But I certainly have it right now. And this not processing certainly is difficult for me, all right? So the spiritual path, what we start out with in spiritual practice, we start out with the confession that this is going to be difficult for me, without question. If it's not difficult for you, you need to go somewhere else where it is difficult, really. So what I bring is it's supposed to be difficult. It's difficult for me. And I assume if it's difficult for me, it's likely to be difficult for most of us. Not necessarily everyone, because there are those who certainly have evaporated more of the continuity problem than I have. But by and large, with some exceptions, if it's difficult for me, it's going to be difficult for everybody. Most everybody. So it's supposed to be difficult. This is all important. It is supposed to be difficult. So when you go into spiritual practice, you should have this attitude like, this is going to be really difficult. For sure. I'm going to feel the heat of this. Yeah, absolutely. It's like going into a sauna. You know it's going to be hot. You know it going in. You don't expect it's going to be air conditioning in a sauna, do you? So, by not processing, by just allowing everything that is said just to be there. We don't have to take a position on it, but we just feel it. You just feel the presence of what's being said. It's pointing to the absolute, non-dual absolute abidance. We're not abiding in any condition. We're not processing anything. Nothing needs to be processed. Nothing needs to be processed, including this statement. Nothing needs to be processed, but it can be heard. And we don't need to be mentally processing what we're hearing. This is the discipline. It's a difficult discipline. You will have consternation within, for sure. So that is why we always practice in the mood of repentance, which is to confess, I have a very severe continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. It's the only problem there is. It's the only problem I'll ever have. There are no other problems to have, actually. This problem is the only problem I or anyone else is ever going to have. So I might as well get working on it, you see. I might as well get working on it. This is the importance. If you recognize this is the only problem that you will ever have, gosh, you got to start working on it. Because it's not going to go away of its own accord. It will stay with you for as long as you want it to. But you'll never have any other problem. You can't find another problem, actually. It's impossible. So all this search for some other problem seems easier to deal with. You'll never find it. You still have this very severe continuity problem. It is severe. But we have a way to evaporate this problem. And so spiritual practice is this recognition, okay, this is going to be really difficult. When I mean difficult, consternation, inner consternation. Consternation is a good way to refer to it, right? It's like what's being said, like just, wow. Don't react, don't interpret. Don't try to interpret it. Don't try to process what's being said. Don't try to come up with examples. Don't try to do anything with it. Just hear it. Don't say yes, don't say no. Just say, you can say, wow. Maybe wow is the best thing, just wow. Wow. See, it doesn't say wow, yes, wow. No, it is wow. It's like wow, consternation, holy cow. There's never been any birth. You know, continuity problem is the only problem there is. Vision oneness is the only value there is. There is no other value. That's it. All of this brings about a sense of consternation. And then you just abide with that in stillness. And just keep your attention available for what's being said, what's being pointed out. And every time you do this, next time, it's easier. And you can go even stronger declarations and realizations than before. And then those will kick up consternation like before, but you've gone much further. You've gone much closer to abidance in the absolute, in no position at all. No need for any position at all. No need for any processing at all. The process-free reality. Just the conscious acceptance, okay, I'm not going to process anything, that in itself gives a deep burn. I'm telling you, I'm feeling it, like, wow. Remember, the purpose of the videos is to give yourself time to work through this consternation and let it settle down. We're intentionally stirring it up. You have to. Because that's the resistance. That's the continuity fear. That's the resistance. We need to stir it up, you know, and air it out. And as we finally settle down, the trouble will be less. It's all been loosened up. We keep breaking up the ice, letting it melt. There's a big block of ice. We keep breaking it and helping it melt. Block of fear, huge block of fear, and we're just breaking it up. Okay, it helps to break it up. It melts faster. This is what we're, you know, you theoretically you can melt it slowly, but who's to say that some deep freeze won't come and freeze it all up at some point? Yeah, of course it will. We need to do it fast. Melt it fast. Break it up, melt it fast. So, of course, when we break up the ice more and more, we're like, wow, this is really incredible. There's not much ice left, you know, holy cow. Don't interpret, don't process. Process-free reality. Nothing to process, nothing to interpret. nothing to no interpretation necessary reality, no interpretation necessary. So the videos are long. A lot of people don't watch them through, but the benefit is to watch them through if possible, just so you can get that consternation. Keep it going, keep it going. Keep the burn going. Keep hearing more and more stuff that's just like, wow, 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 wow. This is difficult. It's sort of a suffering to it, but it's a very welcome suffering. It's the most welcome suffering there is. Just like a sauna, there's suffering. Like, wow, it's hot in here, but I know it's really, helping my health out somehow. Don't know exactly how, but we can feel the refreshment afterwards. We feel it's helped us. Same thing here. So you don't want to just take a 2-minute sauna or a 5-minute sauna. You take the half an hour, or get the full experience, and that's what really gives progress. That really, really helps us. The actual, spending the full effect. Feel the full effect of it. Feel the full effect. Process-free reality. And the mind, the intellect says, give me something to process. Please give me something to process. And we say, hey, freedom. The process-freeness. The pure purity. Or the reality-free reality. And the intellect says, I can't do anything with that. I can't process that, right? So when we speak here, we speak in ways that cannot be processed, actually, to help with this. Remember, we're getting to where we can accept that God is everywhere. God, everything is totally situated perfectly in God. In fact, there's no way for anything to get out of sorts with God at all. That's why the great mystics can say, I see God and everything is perfect. With God, in relation to God, everything is perfect. Always. There's no way for it not to be. It's perfectly abiding in the pure spaciousness, the zero-dimensionality of God. There's no instability whatsoever. So there's absolute stillness, the absolute stillness of perfection. Is always present to be seen, literally to be seen. Now, this is a spiritual quality we're talking about. So the body's eyes, the perceptual mechanism that we have our attention on is not going to point this out to us. But our attention does not have to solely rest upon, the perceptual mechanism of the flesh. It doesn't have to be fixated on that, actually. And when we see this, there's nothing to process. There's nothing to process. As soon as we shift into processing it, it's gone. It's gone. You see, so we have to practice not processing. Not processing. That's the neti, 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 not this, not this, not this. And the mind says, can I process this? No, that's not it. Can I process this? Oh, no, that's not it. Can I process this? That's not it. Not it, not it, not it. Oh. And of course, this causes consternation. So we consciously, intentionally bring up the consternation by stating the truth of the situation. By using words in a way that we feel we can't process what's being said, but it still points to process freeness. Freeness, process freeness. So these are the exercises, these are the affirmations, the declarations, a lot of them. Where am I really? I'm in the process-free reality. I'm in the process-free reality. Where am I really? where am I really? Now, holding like a statement like this, which is a question, and not processing it, is very powerful. Because the mind says, okay, I'm going to find out where I am. I'm going to start thinking about, no, it's not a question, it's a statement. Where am I really? Where am I really? Now, when you refuse to process this, you know, it causes some consternation. You're used to hearing something like this and immediately going into processing mode, but now we're not going into processing mode. Where am I? Where am I really? Where am I really? Where am I really? Where am I really? Who am I really? Who am I really? What am I really? What am I really? Where am I really? Where am I really? Now they call this listening with your heart, but that's more of, this is a way of saying not listening with your head, which is a way of saying not listening with your intellect, thinkingness, okay? And they assume that's located in the head. It's really a belief system. But we just make these ideas, this the way of talking. Well, listen with your heart. It's not really your heart that's listening. But we tend to think, oh, okay, it's located. I need to listen with this location where my heart is or something. No, you don't have to think about the body at all in these terms. It's just... don't process it. Don't process it. And what you feel is an overall burn, consternation that just doesn't really seem to have any particular location. You know, don't try to locate it anywhere in the body at all, really. It's better if it's just this overall sense, overall feeling, just like, wow. Don't try to label it, or where is this, and what's the label? It's just the burn, it's the consternation. Consternation of not processing something that you think you should process, right? Because when we're told stuff, we think to be smart, we're supposed to process it. But what we're doing here is preparing ourselves for the process-free reality. So the question of smartness needs to be dismissed. We're not trying to be smart. See, we're not trying to be smart. They say, well, if you don't try to be smart, you're going to be dumb. No. We are preparing for the process-free reality, which is neither smart nor not smart, which is completely not contained in any categories whatsoever. It's not contained in any categories. It's uncontainable. So we're also practicing uncontainableness. Non-packaging. Don't package it. Don't package it. Let it remain unpackaged, what's being said. Don't package it. This brings the greatest consternation. I can't package this. It's terrible. This strain that we go through, consternation that we go through, that helps us greatly. What's Jesus going to say when you meet Jesus? Jesus is going to say, reality is process free, is what Jesus is going to say. So if you've already accepted this, accepted the challenge, accept this ordeal, if you've already put yourself through the ordeal, that's not going to bother you. not. There's only a certain amount of ordeal there is, and it has to do with the non-dual absolute abidance, the zero, the isness. So the practice, you know, right on this practice, this is, you know, shedding the continuity fear. It is evaporating it, for sure. The non-dualness. Yeah, where are you located? The everywhere free everywhereness. The location free. Location freeness. I'm in the location freeness, the everywhere everywhereness. So affirmation wrap needs to be understood. Now I can do shorter videos, but then if I do shorter video, you have to set aside some time for the burn, absolutely, and then the honoring of what you just done. As I say, don't do spiritual practice less than an hour. Don't do it less than an hour. I feel that actually can bring some problems if you do it less than an hour. Now, if you're a complete beginner, you give it 5 minutes, then give it 10, and then work up to 15. You see, and gradually, you give yourself some time. If you're a complete beginner, most of us are not complete beginners. And so an hour is necessary to really put yourself through the ordeal. So you've really gotten somewhere. And then go through the honoring of the response, the breakthrough, what you've done. Don't flee from it, detach from it real quickly. Stay with it. Just stay with it. So I know I'm going to stay. Even though the insights have stopped, the burn is not so bad. You see, I'm going to honor this, what I'm doing here. I'm going to make an effort of will to say, this is all important, what I'm doing. It's all important. Now, my relationship with Jesus has changed over the 36 years that I've been working on it, actually. A great deal. I'm not, you know, nearly as frightened as I was. That's what 36 years of evaporation will do. I've evaporated a lot of the fear, Still some remaining. So I keep on working. So you have to steal the time from the day to do it. Steal the time from the day. Now, I could put some practice at the beginning of the tape, and then people want to then go off and quietly let the burn go through that process. That's fine too. They don't have to watch through the entire tape. But what I do is I continually bring up perspectives that keep the burn going, you know, keep throwing logs on the fire during the videos, keep throwing logs on the fire. Keep turning the heat up. Once you get used to a certain level of heat, turn it up some more. I say a mind is a terrible thing to use, right? It means, of course, processing. Belief in processing is terrible. What do we call computers? Processors. Okay. What is the problem of the world right now? Everybody thinks that processing is where it's at. which is exactly opposite of the truth. No processing is where it's at. There's nothing to process. Everything is perfect where it is, where it will always be. No matter where anything may ever go, it's always exactly where it's always been. And this can be seen, this can be recognized. It's obviously a holistic recognition, right? If I say everything, no matter where anything may ever go or find itself, no matter where anything at all may ever go, everything is always exactly where it has always been. Everything. So how can you process this? Process means bits and pieces. You take this, you take this, you take this, and this. You're processing bits and pieces, right? What is there to process in an absolute statement like that? There's nothing to process, is there? And so those who are dominated by the intellect and mind and processing will say, oh, nothing to process there. Okay, nothing to process. Whereas those who have done the work of evaporating the continuity fear will say, ah, this just like gives me a buzz. I'm just like, wow, nothing to process. I love that. Love it. Really love it. Just as fantastic. Thank you. I'll take some more of that. There's this old commercial of aftershave. Was it Old Spice or something? Ah, slap in the face. Oh, thanks. I needed that. Yes. Wow. That's great. No offense. Thank you very much. I really needed that. That tremendous. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I always thank the Holy Spirit the most when it gives me something I can't process. It's, you know, just cannot process. Wow. Wherever anything may ever go, wherever be, no matter where anything ever goes, no matter where anything ever finds itself, it is exactly where it's always been. It is exactly where it's always been. Everything. So everything right now is exactly where it's always been. Everything a billion years from now will all be exactly where it's always been. Everything that's ever arisen has always been exactly where it's always been. All motion that takes place is always exactly where it's always been. Now, seeing, recognizing this as nirvana, okay? And we're trying to demystify nirvana, 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 nirvana. Yes, nirvana, yes, yes, yes. Yes, I'm in nirvana. I say, yes, I am in nirvana. Yes, I'm in nirvana. Or in, well, yes, nirvana is what? Nirvana is? I see nirvana. I'm experiencing nirvana. Yes, I'm experiencing nirvana. Okay, we say, yes, I'm experiencing nirvana. Yes, I'm experiencing nirvana. Everything, all motion is all, this instant, this very instant, everything is exactly where it's always been. This next instant, this instant now, is everything is exactly where it's always been. This instant, everything is exactly where it's always been. This instant, everything is exactly where it's always been. What is there to process there? Nothing to process, right? Nirvana is just, you know, you realize nothing to process. Process free. Nothing to process. It's process free because there's nothing to process. Everything is exactly where it's always been. And you say, whoa, 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 pure spaciousness, pure spaciousness, pure spaciousness has no quality to it whatsoever. There's no way that you can say you're ever in a different place relative to pure spaciousness. And there's no relative to it. You're in it. Everything is abiding in pure spaciousness. You can never be anywhere else. You can never be anywhere else. Nothing can ever be anywhere else. Nothing to process. Process-free reality. you know, Christians say, hey, I want to walk with the Lord. I want to learn how to walk with the Lord, is what they say. Walk with Jesus. Absolutely. That's what I want. That's my goal. But if you walk with Jesus, you can walk with anyone, right? So it's not exclusively, I'm not saying exclusively. No, I want to walk with Longjempa too, Ramana Maharshi, Bunjaji, Ananda Mahima. In fact, I want to walk with everyone. St. Francis, all the apostles, everybody from every tradition, you know. I don't speak of Islam because Islam is, you know, strict monotheism, and they don't see a Trinity, which I understand what they're saying. All is one, there's only one. That's perfectly fine. But the arguments over that, you know, it can get sticky. So I don't want to put anyone on the spot or anything, but truly, there's only one God. That's for sure. There's only one God. There's only the oneness. There's only the isness. There's only the pure spaciousness. That's what they're pointing at, all right, which is great. But I don't want to get involved in the dialectic of, you know, well, there's the Trinity isn't right, or this, and you know, you get into spiritual intellectualism at that point of trying to see what, you know, is there really difference there or not, etc. And you can argue endlessly on that. We don't want to do that. But of course, absolute respect to all. Absolute respect to all. There's always one. Absolute respect to the oneness, which all is. So, I mean, this is strict monotheism. There's only monotheism. There's only one. There's only one. And you can talk about theological fine points. We're interested in being able to walk with the Lord, walk with in the process free, walk with Nirvana, walk with Buddha, absolutely. Walk with all the Buddhas. There have been many Buddhas, actually. We're all Buddhas. We're all Christs. There's only one. There's only one. So to walk with Jesus, of course. That's so Christians are supposed to have, their purpose in life is to use their time wisely to evaporate the continuity fear so they can walk with Jesus. Absolutely, Jesus wants to walk with everybody and is walking with us. We just don't notice. He's right beside us, actually. Right with us. So we're supposed to use our lives that way, and our time and our effort that way. That is the responsibility of a Christian. That is the responsibility. And it should be, you know, it's taken very seriously. In fact, there's nothing that even is remotely as serious as that. Because if you're not walking with Jesus, you're walking alone. See what I'm saying? You're walking in interpretation, the loneliness of interpretation. And that's hell. If you're not walking with Jesus, you're walking in hell. The loneliness of interpretation, of processing. That's hell. And by Jesus, of course, I mean spirit. Spirit. That's a name for spirit with no continuity problem. Okay? Spirit with no continuity problem at all. Okay? We can give it a label, you know. But it's not exclusive. I know Christians get wrapped up in that sometimes, but overall, walk with the Lord. You have to walk with the Lord. That's your purpose, and it's process free. So if you're saying, well, you're exclusive or that, there's no exclusivity in reality at all. Reality is reality free. There's no exclusivity at all. There's only the isness. There's no concept of exclusivity. All is all. All is all. All is all. All is all. All is exactly where it's always. All is exactly always all. Everywhere is exactly everywhere. Everywhere is always everywhere. Everywhere is always everywhere. Okay? Everywhere is always everywhere. Everywhere is always everywhere. That's why I say there's no birth. There's no birth. There's no birth. There's no birth. Why everywhere is always everywhere. There's nowhere for any birth. Everywhere is always everywhere. The inescapable. God is completely inescapable. God is completely inescapable. So, being of any religion, okay, where you're working to walk with your symbol of spirit, completely free of any continuity issue whatsoever, completely process-free spirit, totally process-free, whatever syllables, words, sounds you want to use for that, is fine. Some are more particular about that than others, but it's all one, so there's no exclusivity. The reality is exclusivity free. Yeah, it's the most serious responsibility there is, period. So, your life, your community, your culture, your friends, your family, everything should be taken seriously. You should be around those who also take it seriously. Very seriously, as their responsibility, okay? Not fanatically, okay? Fanaticism has to do with arguments. That's the intellect is involved with that, over-involved. Over-involvement with the intellect. Taking it serious means, hey, I gotta practice. I gotta actually practice to burn, you know? The consternation of it's process-free. The non-exclusivity of reality, the complete, pure non-exclusivity, the traceless, the boundless, the fathomless, the spaceless spacelessness. It's process-free, and I have to practice the consternation. I have to spend time at this, I have to spend effort at this. This is all important. It's all important because I want to be able to walk with God, walk with the Lord, walk with Spirit. I don't want to keep walking all alone, lonely, and afraid in the hell of processing and thinking and trying to figure out. That's hell. That's absolutely is hell. But if you don't burn away the continuity, evaporate the continuity fear, you will continue to walk in hell, no question about it. There's absolutely no question about it. There's nowhere else to be. When you're denying reality, there's nowhere else to be except in denial. That's where you are, which is really continuity fear. If you don't evaporate the continuity fear, there's no other experiencing you can have except the continuity fear. And of course you'll be projecting it, trying to get rid of it, and then that just enmeshes you in hell. All sorts of conflict and attack and agitation and drama and, you know, the whole play of humanity is the play of the continuity fear unacknowledged. It's the play of non-repentance. You're going to be in the play of non-repentance. Either you're in the play of repentance or the play of non-repentance. There isn't any other play to be in. Saying there's another play is the play of non-repentance, actually. It's failing to recognize what repentance is. If you recognize what it is, you'll know it's either or. So, this is such an all-important, serious issue. Though those who are non-repentant don't take it seriously at all. Okay, and this is the problem with the world right now, isn't it? There's too many people in this world who don't take it seriously, and there's also too many fanatics who want to avoid actually practicing it by acting out, scapegoating, acting out, arguing over trivial stuff, quibbling, and getting all worked up and upset over what is non-practicing. In other words, they're getting upset about how to process, they're arguing, how do we process this accurately? The answer is you don't process it. You see, the whole problem is people saying, well, how do we process this? And they say, well, how do I get it? I don't need to get it. Reality is not something I get. You can't grasp it, you can't get it, you can't reach it, you can't attain it, you cannot learn it. You just have to be it. You have to be it. Process free, be it. Just nirvana, 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 nirvana is. So there's too much irresponsibility taking place in the world now. Too many who seem to be very unrepentant in the play of non-repentance. And they are seizing control of the culture. And saying it, saying, we want a non-repentant culture, we want a non-repentant world, we want the attention of this world exclusively focused on non-repentance. That's what they're saying. Now, this is very unacceptable. We'll see what Jesus will do, we'll see what Spirit will do about this. It's entirely unacceptable. It's just wandering in the wilderness for a long time. They say, hey, we want to wander in the wilderness for a really long time. No thanks. Been there, done that. No thanks. So, when you know how terrible it is to wander in the wilderness and somebody insists that you must continue to do so for a long, long time, that is not a welcome demand at all. It's a very, very, very unwelcome demand. And they're basically saying, hey, there isn't anyone to walk with. There's no Jesus to walk with. That's what they're saying. You know, that's a very unwelcome demand to say that. Stipulation. They say, no, your attention must be on processing. Computers, smartphones, tablets, laptops, devices of all, gadgets of all type. They say your attention must be on processing. Okay? Whereas we know in spirit intuitively and from all the great realizers in history, and there have been many, 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 many in all traditions, we know we have to practice this process freeness. We have to get used to it. We have to move our comfort zone. Gradually, bit by bit, gradually. This takes time and effort, dedication, focus, determination, discipline, perseverance, patience, all of these virtues. These virtues are super important. And it takes support from others who say, yeah, this is the right way to use your time. Great. I'm so glad you're using your time in this way. When have you ever heard that? I've never heard that someone say, hey, I'm so good. Well, almost never. This video channel has gotten some good feedback, but in terms of people around me, you never hear, what are you doing? I'm just sitting here quietly, not processing anything. Huh? You know, what are you doing wasting your life like that? You know, you're supposed to be successful. How can you be successful if you don't process? What are you talking about? But we should hear from everyone around us how I'm so absolutely just thrilled. I just think it's the best thing ever that you're spending time moving your comfort zone into process freeness. That's tremendous use of time. Way to go. That's fantastic. I'm giving you an award right now. You get the award right now. Where do we get that kind of affirmation, confirmation. And so this is a collective cultural effort. Right spiritual discipline is a collective cultural effort where people reinforce one another and saying, thanks so much for doing that. And they act and they dress and they speak in a total way to support others doing this. Give them the space, give them the time, and just say that this is wonderful. Being responsible like this is the best thing ever. It's the best, highest calling in the world, with nothing else even comes close. Nothing else is even on the map. This is it. There's nothing else we need to do. And don't process that either. The intellect wants to jump in and process it. No, there's nothing else we need to do. There is absolutely nothing else we need to do. Listen to the term need. There's nothing else we need to do. All needs of the body are actually projected upon the body by the continuity fear. This is something that's been pointed out to me. All body needs are actually projected onto the body by the continuity fear as an excuse I say, no, I need to do something else other than, you know, move my comfort zone into the process arenas. But since we do have quite a bit of continuity fear, we will find ourselves continuing to function normally, eating, sleeping, working, whatever. But all I need to do is move my comfort zone into the profit, process freeness. That's all I need to do. That's it. I don't need to do anything other than that. Don't need to do anything other than that. Hear that. Don't need to do anything other than that. So, we're told there's an end time, we're told there's a parting of the ways, we've been told this in Scripture. And it certainly seems that this is going to occur when the processing capability of this world suddenly goes completely quantum, where that inherently creates a split between seeing practicing process freeness as the only that is on the map. Only that is on the map. That's the only thing I need to do. Only that is on the map of responsibility. And the split between that and those who believe that working on processing more and faster is the right way, is the right way. Okay. So this has already occurred. This split is already here. It's already here. So it's extremely likely that the return of Christ is here, right? It's extremely likely. Because if it's not here, if not here now, there won't be anything to separate very much longer, because everyone will be sucked into the black hole of putting their attention on processing, right? Everyone is going to get sucked into that black hole, and there won't be anybody to save. There won't be anybody to say, "Hey, Jesus, I really have all this momentum into not processing." We'll be sucked down the black hole of processing if something doesn't take place soon. And it you know, I don't know. I cannot. It's hard to fathom what it could be exactly. But it's also very hard to fathom how this world could shed its obsession with processing. Because that's what's necessary. Otherwise, who wants to stay here? Who knows the absolute importance of practicing process-free, and having cultural world support for this? Family, community, friends, neighborhood, cultures, you know, your area, everything. Social support for process-free and knowing that that is the way to go. How in the world is this world going to go into that from where it is right now? I mean, and still be a stable situation, right? How in the world is that possible? You know, I don't think it's remotely plausible that that's possible. You can always throw up saying, well, you can't rule it out entirely. Well, from a pragmatic, practical standpoint, certainly we can. Certainly we can. You know, pragmatism can certainly rule out certain outcomes. It would be stupid not to. It would be impractical not to. How we can go from where we are now as a world, as a culture, to simply dropping all that and going back to this completely simple, non-process based practicing of process freeness. The likelihood of that is zero, isn't it? It's zero, zero likelihood. everybody, all the young people in the world are absolutely being drilled in processing is the answer. And sure, there's some people who do homeschooling, okay, but it's a drop in the bucket in certainly the overall picture is not one where those who have seen the absolute importance of practicing the process rate are going to somehow be, you know, 99.9% of the people on the planet. And not even half the people, not even a third, not even a 10%, not even 1%. You know, this is a tiny, 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 tiny amount, actually. And this is the testimony of people from around the world in different places giving testimony of saying, hey, there's just not a lot of people around that get this. Okay, there's just not. There is not. Certainly, the actually practicing the process freeness and feeling okay about it and feeling this is it, you know, you could give lip service to it. And I think the New World religion may give lip service to it. Of course, it gives lip service to all this stuff. Does it actually practice it, though? Does it actually set up culture, society, economy, everything to support this practice? Does it actually do that? Oh, no, it doesn't. So it's bogus. It's not pragmatic at all. So all my attempts to get some sort of revival going in the world have failed. And so from my own standpoint, I don't know what else to do. I've tried everything I can do. I've done every effort. I've exerted every effort I can exert, short of standing up on the median of some major roads, Jesus saves today, you know. But I've seen others do that, and it doesn't, you know, it doesn't work. So you have to learn from what others have done. And it's a valuing situation where the world's valuing processing. And I say there's no value to processing, actually. I value the vision of oneness. The only value there is the vision of oneness. There is no other value. There's no other value whatsoever. So I categorically reject as a value all processing as a value. Now, practically, some processing takes place in this world. It takes place, but that's it. It just takes place. We do it. You know, that's it. Don't put your mind on it. Don't try to expand it. Don't think it's ingenious. Don't think anything about it. Just whatever practical, pragmatic steps you take, okay? But that's it. That's it. Keep it simple. Keep it absolutely simple. The situation in this world is designed for chaos. And what is chaos? Complexity. It's designed to make it feel like everything is so complex that we need more processing. More processing. More and more and more and more and more and more. So everyone has to be hooked up to some super, 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 super duper computer, right? And they say only that can, you know, resolve all this complexity and that kind of stuff. It's set up for that. People keep losing their passwords, their financial data. Everything's at risk now. It's like your whole life is at risk because it can vanish electronically, processing-wise. That's no place to excel in practicing process freeness. Now, in the past, small communities would spring up in desert areas. Okay, they'd get away from the world. They go way out in some oasis, 1,000 miles from anywhere. And they would practice super simple living. I think the Essenes that Jesus was a part of is an example of that. Tend to stay away from, you know, others who are into processing. And they teach the simplicity and practice the process freeness. So the world's always had that going. Monasteries, nunneries, retreats, top of some mountain, inaccessible places. We always miss, I want to get away, very inaccessible. Keep the maniacs away. And so we could say, well, we can do that, etc. But I think it's a little different right now with all the satellites, with all the technology, where the goal here is to bring processing to everyone. To everyone. Everyone. That's Google's goal, of course. It's the goal of all the techies. Is they feel it's like a vaccination. You know, you need to be vaccinated against non-process belief. You need to be vaccinated against the belief in non-process. They see that as like some kind of severe disease that you need to be vaccinated against. Literally, that's how they see it. They see us who practice getting used to non-process, wonderful non-processing, which gets us ready to shift our attention to the non-dual absolute being, isness. They see that as some kind of severe mental disease that is going to cause us incredible unhappiness. This is all projection on their part. They're actually projecting their own situation, which is severe mental disease, severe unhappiness. They project it onto others because they can't bear to see it in themselves because they don't know what to do about it. So they have this terrible projection problem. And we don't want to have that projected on us, you see. That's not a good thing to have that projected on us at all. Because then they want to vaccinate us. To cure us. They want to cure us. They don't realize they're the ones that need to be cured. But we do. We do. So we cannot put up with this nonsense. We cannot agree to this nonsense. No. They're the ones in need of vaccination, actually. Vaccination of truth. Simplicity, discipline, etc. So, they're determined to vaccinate everyone on the planet. That's where all this money is going. This is what the whole command and control system of the planet, technologically speaking, the goal is to vaccinate every last person on this planet, without a single exception. That's their goal. Keep this in mind. This is a different playing game that's being played. Before, you could take off into the desert and live there for, you know, generation after generation, and nobody would bother you. Nowadays, with all these satellites, with all these imaging, with everything they've got, they can locate any person anywhere on this planet, actually. Almost. The ways, I mean, you can live underground, you know, some people used to do that, some Christians. Cappadocia would, you know, got like how many stories underground, 14 stories underground or something, and they, you know, they just live like troglodytes underground. But they'll find those too, the heat radiation, they'll find everybody on the planet, and like missionaries, hey, we understand that you may have not been vaccinated. Well, we're here with the good news, we're here to vaccinate you, there's a very severe virus going around. We need to vaccinate you for this. They may use pandemics as an excuse, actually, to actually introduce biotech into you. Nanotechnology. They may put nanotechnology in vaccines. They're vaccinated against, like, pandemics. And then they can tried to vaccinate everybody in the world, but at the same time introduce nanotechnology into their bodies, into their brains, like that, thinking that they're going to cure people from this dreaded disease of loving non-process. People have been warning, you know, something like this. Well, of course, put nothing past them, actually. Now, so, do we want a bunch of nanotechnology introduced into us? Do we want, they may put, actually, let me tell you what they are going to do, is they are going to put nanotechnology in the drinking water. They're going to put nanotechnology in the drinking water. That's going, you drink the water, that's going to get into you. I've been drinking steam distilled water for a long, long time, actually. they're getting everybody used to adding stuff to water, adding stuff to water. Well, they'll start adding nanotechnology to water. They say, well, how else are we going to, that's the fastest way to inoculate everybody or something, you know. They'll figure out something says, this nanotechnology is going to actually, they probably won't even tell anyone, but they'll say, well, we're helping the immune system, blah, 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 whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. See, we get used to the light. We're in the shadows. We get used to the light. Here in the shadows. Get used to the light. Here in the shadows. You see, more and more and more. Get used to the light. Get used to the light. Get used to the light. Like that. It's not a problem. See, the light is one. No processing. It just is. All right. And this is all pertinent because Ebola is rolling. You know, Ebola, boulders. Woo. That's interesting. That's very interesting because the collapse I saw coming was symbolized to me by this massive collapse of boulders. Rolling boulders. Ebola. Ebola is a ball, isn't it? Ebola? Ebola. Could be the E standing for high tech, actually, you know. The e-book, e this. Ebola. A combination of nanotechnology and the Ebola virus or whatever. But that's interesting. It may be some kind of massive pandemic. It's like this collapse that is coming. And this Ebola thing, people are saying, wow. Now, I don't see how this is possible. But it could be something along those lines. I don't know. It's because it's easily contained in a proper hospital situation, you know. But what happens in all the hospitals? Here's the problem with Ebola, and we're starting to see it, is a lot of these countries where it's starting to become a pandemic, they have very limited hospital space. And what happens when all the hospital beds of super high security protection, right, has to be contained very carefully in hospitals? What happens when all the beds are full and the streets are full of people with Ebola? What do they do then? See, this is the problem. There's only a limited amount of space and medical capacity in those places. And they're flying these people out of the country to relatives all over the world, you know. Wow. So it potentially, I mean, it seems almost impossible. But I did get this dream of all these boulders, huge boulders rolling over everything, causing this massive worldwide collapse. Huge boulders, Ebola. Bola, boulders. I don't know. There's some similarity to that. It wouldn't be that big of a surprise if there's something like that, because the whole thing is all linked together, right? They want to vaccinate everyone. They want to get rid of everybody, vaccinate everyone that's left, so everyone is free of this dreaded disease of spiritual aspiration, of practicing process freeness. I am process free. I am still as God created me. I am process free, for I am spirit as God created me. I am process free, for I am spirit as God created me. I zipped over here. There could be lots of stuff coming now. I said August is likely when it's going to blow up. I remember I've said that in many videos. Early August, what happened? Ebola. Started becoming a major problem, right? In August this year, ISIS started becoming an incredible problem. August this year. I said August, you've got to be ready before August, okay? You have to be more oriented towards process freeness than not by August of 2014. That's why I put on this massive push in July, June, July, just, you know, I kept pushing everybody. July, what, 16th, I was shipped, I was ready before August. I got ready before August. Where I say I'm more comfortable with process freeness than with process. You know, the scales have tipped. Scales have tipped. There's no question the scales have tipped in my life. I reached these milestones, many milestones I'm reaching, that prove to me that I'm, you know, tipped the scales. I tipped it. That's all you have to do is tip the scales. So hopefully you've tipped the scales. I've did everything I could possibly do to encourage people to work like maniacs towards that goal. Because it's necessary now. Because here comes, you know, here come the horsemen of the apocalypse. And you know, ISIS is not a joke, actually. They are willing to do anything at all. They've shown that, right? They have shown that they have no rules or scruples whatsoever. I mean, they're way worse than anything that came before, right? So they get their hands on the wrong stuff. You know, look out. We're so this is all happening. Israel, Gaza thing, August, okay? All this stuff is happening in August as I said it would. As I passed it on to you, I was told it would. You have to be ready before August of 2014. Ready meaning shift the balance of acceptance towards non-process, process freeness. Your comfort is more there than in processing. It's more there. Now, I can still process, but my interest is dwindling, you know, very much dwindling. Very much dwindling in my process. As Jesus always tells us, you don't have to be 100%, it's just the balance, just more towards more comfortable with process freeness than with process. That's all that's required, he says. That is all that is required. So just check in with yourself and see, you know, where you're at with that. So right on cue, the four horsemen of the apocalypse are starting to ride. You got you've got situations that are suddenly becoming very, there's a certain different feel to them, right? I mean, there's the Ebola thing. This is nasty. ISIS, very nasty situation in the Middle East, Israel, Gaza, all this stuff. Very nasty. Stuff is getting very nasty. You know, the pressure being put on Russia, very nasty situation there, actually, very much so. Just, you know, Russia does not like to be disrespected the way they have been, and so we say, well, it's justified. Well, justified or not, nobody likes to be disrespected in a global way like this. No, nobody, right? So it's a very nasty situation, the Ukraine situation, etc. But in August, we could be looking at another big situation coming up very soon, actually. That's, I've been giving a heads up, hey, don't be surprised if another horseman of the apocalypse is right in August. Another bowl is being poured out. The bowls, the angels are pouring the bowls out upon the world right now. And people are saying, uh-oh, how do we process this? Don't have to process it, you know. There is a land, there is a place that does not induce process processing where you feel like, hey, it's okay to be process free here. I call it the death free realm, some higher realms. There is a place, maybe places, where it's okay to be process free. I don't need to process anything. I can be process free. It feels very okay. The place welcomes it. The place welcomes it. It says, I'm here for you. Who want to practice process freeness, I'm here for you. This realm is here for you. Thank you. This place here is certainly not, because the chaos that's becoming is only going to make people process freaks, you know? They're going to become process freaks. I'm telling you, I've been housebound for quite some time, more or less. I go out to get groceries and about nothing else. And I went out to a car wash yesterday, and wow, people, it was so freaky. It was really freaky. They're so completely obsessed with processing. They're ferocious. You know, just this ferocious attitude I was just noticing. Wow. Holy cow. So everyone's on process steroids. their motors are really humming. A lot of freakiness. So it's going to get off the charts very soon. Is those process freaks will jump up and say, okay, we're here, solve the problem, don't worry. More processing. We'll process everybody. Let's process everybody. In fact, let's get all citizens go through a process here. We'll process them and say, you go here, you know, martial law, let's process everything. You know, it's possible. All this stuff is very possible, actually, very possible. What's Jesus going to do, for instance? What are the people who are more oriented toward process freeness? How about them? What's their situation? Well, it seems like the door may be open very soon. In fact, it's already open. We just haven't turned our attention there. It's already open. I've seen this. Remember, this world is just a little room in a big mansion. And the little room is not detached from the rest of the mansion. It's just a thin little wall there. We walled ourselves off from the rest of the mansion thinking that, oh, we're separate. We're in the world. This is all there is. This is it, this world. That is absolutely, you know, just ludicrous. Imagine if you're in a house, you live in a room, and you wall off the room, and you stay in your room, don't go out, and then you start thinking, this little room I'm in, that's all there is. That's all there is. There isn't any place else. There's nowhere else for me to go. I can't go through the door then because there's nowhere else to go. This is it. I'll go into an abyss if I do that. So I wall off the door, you know, sheetrock it, whatever. There's no door there. Well, the house is still there. You know, you're just hiding in your little room. The house, there's just a thin wall between you and the rest of the house. That's it. But what if you were just take out the sheetrock and there's a nice door there now, right? It's like, Oh, there's a door. Oh, I see a room. There's another room. Interesting. I wonder what's in that other room. Maybe I can take a look. Maybe I take a peek. That's the real situation. We live in this vast mansion, and it's all one. Our room is in this mansion, and we can simply... There's rooms everywhere. There's room everywhere. There's a house everywhere. So there are many dwelling places. That's what Jesus told us. He said, if it were not so, I would have told you. So, of course, those who lean more towards process freeness are saying, hey, you know what? I think I'm ready to be welcomed into a better situation. I am ready to be welcomed into a better situation. Process freaks, you know, no. That's a circus. I'm not interested in attending, going to a circus right now, you see. Been there, done that. It's the midway. It's all the sideshows, all the sideshow booths, all the freak geeks are there. The big tent is there, all this circus stuff, circus stuff. No, I'm not interested in any circus. So this world's gonna be, you know, become this circus. It's already, I mean, I saw all these freaks. They said these people belong in a circus. Really? Really, 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 really? It's off the charts. You know, worshiping the god of the Moloch of process. They're all like, how can I worship you more? How can I show you my worshipfulness more, great goddess of process? And you know, they'll keep thinking, huh, what can I do to show my fanaticism even more? Oh, I'm gonna be even more freaky, and they get more and more freaky, more and more freaky, more and more freaky. You know. Pretty soon everyone will be like tattooing the insides of their body, you know. Inserting all sorts of stuff all over their body, tattooing the outside, the inside of the eyelids, putting LED lights everywhere, you know, process, fanatical processors, you know, absolutely fanatical. And they'll seize control because they, you know, there's these shows now. I was watching the golf, and they have these commercials, I think I said that, and just so terrible, so atrocious. And what they're saying is they get an older person. I noticed this show, what's it called, Scorpion or something, this show. and some commercial trailers for it, and they have an older person, they say, you know what? These bad guys are getting too smart for me now. I need help. I need you. Where are they going to? The young geeks, you know, the young process geeks, freaks, the geek freaks. And, you know, you gotta help. I can't deal with the bad guys anymore. Oh, in come the freak geek processors. Oh yeah, okay, don't worry. Yeah, we'll figure it out. We'll process this. And this is getting people ready for what's going to happen, is the older generation will say, people in charge will say, this is just too much for us. You know, I just can't deal with this. We need to call upon the younger people to come in here and help us out. Well, of course, they'll come in there and they'll take over. Absolutely, they're ready to take over. It's like the healthcare fiasco, right, in the website. We just can't do this. We can't figure it out. You've got to bring in these young people to really understand how to do all this stuff. You know, well, we didn't need to actually do that, did we? We didn't really need to do that. Some people can argue back for it, blah, 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 blah. But just the way that it happened, it just shows you it's a trial run. It's a trial run. Bring in the geek freaks, the process freaks, the geek process freaks. And they will be running things. They'll create all these agencies. They'll take over all the agencies. Executive orders. Okay, you're now in charge of this. Oh, boom. And there you go. And that's when probably the chipping will take place, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. They'll say, this is what we need to do. We need to do this. Okay, carte blanche. Okay, we don't quite understand this. So, well, you know. You gotta make sure you do it right. You guys will do it okay. Won't you be? Oh, sure. Do no evil. We won't do any evil. Don't worry. It's all fine. It's all good. We know what we're doing. And everybody worshiping the beast. What is the beast? A processor. Okay, what is the beast? A processor. 666, a replicator, a processor. The beast is processing. Okay? So everybody worshiping the beast means everybody worshiping processing, processors, technology, computers, processing. And the Antichrist is just, they have to say, that's the way to go. That's how we're going to be happy. Eventually we'll learn how to process reality. We just, you know, working on it, that's what they say. Remember, reality is process-free. There's nothing to process. Wherever you go, you're always exactly where you've always been. What is there to process? There's nothing to process. So you need to practice dropping, processing. How can we do that in this world right now? How can we do that? I do it, you know, I'm just like in hiding, you know, hiding like a refugee here. But it's very uncomfortable. It's getting more and more uncomfortable. Because people are getting more and more ferocious. They're really getting ferocious. You know, we should take the sign, imagine, you know, imagine a world, there's no religion, blah, 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 by that knucklehead Lenin. And say, imagine a process-free world. Imagine a world free of processors. And hold up a sign. Imagine a world free of processors. Maybe I'll go to the Apple headquarters and hold up a sign. Imagine a process-free world. You know, what will happen? Probably helicopters will come in. Probably, you know. A SWAT team will come in. Probably, you know. Really? I think they'd put up with that? No. Some biohazard SWAT team will come swooping in there. I think they must have some severe virus that's causing this. You know, gotta put a lockdown, put an isolation unit in the hospital. It must be infected by some severe virus that's causing this reaction. This is a symptom of the reaction. It's transmissible, man. We got to, you know, isolate this one as fast as possible. That's where they're going towards. They're seeing wisdom as a symptom of an infection with some kind of severe disease. This is true, I'm telling you. How freaky is going to get, and you know what I'm talking about, actually. And so does Jesus, right? Don't count out Jesus. Remember, Jesus saves today. Keep that in mind. know, some people think he's just a prophet and his life ended there on Calvary, but I could tell you, deep in my heart, I know he's, you know, there inside of me. Jesus saves today. Jesus saves today. Jesus saves today. Right? Process free. The process free Jesus. The Jesus free Jesus is how I put it. The Jesus free Jesus saves today. The process free Jesus saves today. Not the one you're processing. That one doesn't save. That you're processing doesn't save. Processing Jesus doesn't save. The process free Jesus saves today. Because there's only today. It's always today. It's always, everything is always exactly where it's always been. There's nowhere else to be. There's nowhere else to be other than right here. Where else can Jesus be except right here, right now? There isn't any other place to be. So of course Jesus is here now. The Jesus free Jesus is here now, right here now. Thank you, Jesus, for that. So what's that? What's Jesus going to do? I don't know, but he's giving some hints. Yeah, go to Google headquarters, hold up a sign. Imagine a process-free world. We can do it if we try. Yeah, the employees will just be like, we could have a camera on them, you know, just take a lunatic. Oh my God, 911. Oh my God, you know. OMG, 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 OMG. Oh my God, there's someone out there that's a crazy person infected with a virus or some crazy virus, some weird thing from Africa or something is like, it's causing them to see, imagine a process-free world. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. You know, they'll freak. You know, do people really have the right, constitutional right to completely freak out over free speech? Do they really have that right? What in the Constitution does it say? People have the right to completely freak out. They say, hey, I believe that Jesus is here to save today. Oh my God, complete freak out. We're going to 911, put this person in a mental institution. Oh my God. Where is that right, you see? But they think they have the right. And they keep pushing court cases, pushing legal system in this direction, you know. They get enough executive orders. They just bypass the legal system altogether, which is what has happened. I don't know if that's an experiment I want to try, actually. Post it on YouTube. I wonder how that long my channel will stay up under those circumstances. They've already been fiddling with my processing. I haven't been able to process my videos recently at all. Finally, they're processing now. Maybe it's just a warning. I don't know what's happening. Maybe not. Maybe the Holy Spirit's doing it. You know, give them the benefit of the doubt. Give them the benefit of the doubt. I'm not saying they're intentionally blocking anything, but something was blocking it. My videos were blocked. Last 2 days, been blocked. And I think they're starting to process now. I hope so. I've seen a couple that are processing. So it's always good to inject a little humor here. Just imagine yourself, you know, here in Silicon Valley, going up to Facebook. Let's go to Facebook's campus, you know. Imagine a Facebook-free world. Imagine a process-free world. Yeah. You know, go to Zuckerberg's house, pick at his house. Hey, just hold the sign up on the sidewalk. Imagine a process-free world. Imagine a world free of all processors. Hey, yeah. My God, they'd act like you're the biggest threat to the planet there is in the whole world. Domestic terrorist or something. Oh my God, you're saying process-free, that will collapse our economy. You know, you see what they're going to say? You see what I'm talking about? Is, can you really express the process-free, the non-dual absolute process-free expression in this world? Actually, full on? They're going to say you're trying to collapse the economy of the world. You're trying to collapse the world. That is exactly what they're going to say. They will say you're therefore domestic terrorist. Absolutely. I'll disappear. If you start pushing it like that, most likely, yeah. Absolutely. Because everything now runs on processors, doesn't it? All the vehicles, the entire financial system runs on processors. Everything. So to say, imagine a process-free world. You know, they freak out, but what I'm seeing is, of course, hey, don't process what I'm saying. Just imagine a process for your world. Don't process that. And what do you get? Hey, maybe this is not the only place there is. Maybe there's a realm that's a process-free realm that will welcome this attitude and say, welcome. It's all set up for you. You see, they don't get that. They're busy caught up in their processing. Imagine a process-free world. I'm not necessarily saying this one, okay? I'm not saying necessarily this one, because it's not going to go in that direction, of course not. So imagine a process-free world would be referring to the basic premise of the importance of process-freeness, and that there can be a realm that supports this. Absolutely. And we can go there, right? Absolutely. Because it's just a thin wall. We're actually, just remove the wall and we're there. See, remove the wall, we're there. The little rooms in the big mansion, remove the wall, and we can wander throughout the entire mansion, actually, if we want to. We may find a certain nice, beautiful place in the mansion and say, yeah, I think I'll hang out here for a while in this process-free, well, the place that welcomes process-freeness, I like the hospitality of this place. Place I was in hospitality there was absolutely terrible. Now, I saw in a dream years ago this immense collapse taking place. I fled from that collapse. I made it safely. I went to another place, and I said, hey, you know, I was living this other place, and this collapse happened, and I fled. I said, can I take refuge here? And they said, sure, we know all about it. We know all about what happened. Absolutely. You're totally welcome here. Our place is your place. And I looked around. I said, oh, my God, this place is fantastic. I felt very welcome there. Very welcome there. So, you know, hey, all the cards are on the table now, aren't they? All the cards, it's August, all the cards are on the table. Absolutely, stuff happens in August. Stuff really happens in August, for sure. I first came, you know, across A Course in Miracles in August 1978. Major stuff is going to happen this month. Major stuff is going to happen. So, stay tuned. Hopefully these videos won't be blocked. Maybe I won't go to YouTube headquarters and Google, Apple, whatever. Imagine a process-free world. I could always green screen it, of course. They might not get the joke. I think they lack a sense. They lack the process-free sense of humor. That's another thing I've seen. These process freaks lack a sense of humor. They're clueless about high humor, you know, the true humor. Process-free humor, which is wonderful humor. They don't have a clue. They don't have a clue. My dad was great with that. He loved it, and we would talk, and we'd just crack each other up so much. You know, people who are into that, they can say stuff, and it's so funny. But the process freaks, you're mentally ill. Oh, my God, I'm around mentally ill people. I hope it's not contagious. I hope it's not one of these new, you know, strains of weird stuff going around. Oh, I think I'm freaking out. I think I better call the authorities because I'm freaking out. These people are causing me to freak out. If I freak out, I might not be able to do my IT stuff properly. I might be able to take care of all the processes properly, and the world might collapse. So I've got to get these people away from me and incarcerated as fast as possible. That's what we're headed towards. In fact, we're there. Everybody's been trained to freak out. Because all these people have been trained to freak out. You can tell. They're emotional, and you can tell. We've been constantly programmed to freak out about population, right? You said what? Oh, my God, I'm freaking out. You said what on Twitter? Oh, my God, complete freak out. You said what? We're all completely freaking out. And if you aren't, like, incarcerated right this instant, we're all going to go be completely non-functional. We're so freaked out. If we're non-functional, none of the processing will grind to a halt. And if that happens, the whole world will collapse. So you must be incarcerated immediately. We're already there. It's just a matter of, you know, a few little buttons being pushed here and there. We're already there. The attitudes are there. Everyone's been conditioned for this, you know. But I said what? You know, boom. Freak out. I can't function with these people around. I cannot function anymore. I've had it. It's impossible. Oh, no, we need you to function. Oh, my God, you can't stop functioning. No, I'm not going to function anymore. Forget it, you know. I'm going to go away to some island for not functioning anymore. No, don't do that. Okay, don't worry, we'll take care of these people. They're bothering you. We'll take care of them. Yeah, well, maybe Jesus will take care of us first, you see. Maybe Jesus will take care of us first. Consider that. Don't process it. Don't process it. Just feel it. Feel it. Don't process 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 it. Feel it. So we're at this great divide where these freak out people have planned this freak out thing about wisdom as if it's like so freakish to them they can't function, and without their function the whole world will collapse. So they demand, you know, the banishment, the disappearance of all wisdom on the planet. This has all been planned ahead of time, and Jesus knows about it. I know about it. Jesus knows about it because it's been shared with me. Many people understand this, actually. You know, if you understand this, you're not alone, that is for sure. We're just kind of bringing the more intense clarity to it. Like, maybe worse than I thought. You know, I've been telling you all along, hey, some really bad stuff is coming. Bad, 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 bad stuff. And way more than you think. This is it. Now you're seeing. It's the freak out plan. It's the freak out one freaking out. If you don't worship and obey processing, you said, what? I can't go to work. And in fact, none of us can go to work. You've got to leave here immediately. In fact, you're a detriment to society. You're a danger to society. Because we all have to worship processing. If we don't worship processing, none of us will be able to live. Nobody will be able to survive. It'll cause the death of everybody. You know, you see what we're saying? Why we go down this road of processing. What a dangerous road it was. And I knew it from the beginning. I said, don't go down this road. It's a trap. It's a trap. Right? It's a trap. And many people understand this. But doesn't matter, there's still, the trap has already been set. The trap has been set. And there will be this great, you know, war, this ideological war, which is all contrived, because freakoutness is something that people intentionally work on, build up as a trick to claim, you know, oh, I am inherently completely freaked out about your attitude, so I can't even function. They've intentionally got themselves up into a, you know, the senoritas in South America, the Spanish countries, they're known for hysteria, you know, and it's something they actually practice. They learn it and say, wow, this is a great technique. Oh, I fainted. And all it used to be all around the world, women, some women would, they would be able to faint, you know, people, men do, but usually it's the women say, oh, I fainted, you know, just literally faint. I got a fit of the vapor, I just fainted. It's used to control, oh, you freaked me out. Oh, I went hysterical, I went crazy, I'm gonna die. My blood pressure, I'm going, because you're freaking me out. You can't do that, you're gonna kill me. It's, they intentionally develop this reaction as a tool of oppression, a tool of control over others. It's something they're able to control their blood pressure, their physical reactions. You can actually control your physiological reactions if you work at it enough and you want to do that. Some people can go into coughing spells, you know, fits and everything. It's just, it's a way to demand control. It's a way to demand control. But Jesus teaches forgiveness, 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 forgiveness. Nothing freaks Jesus out at all. Nothing freaks Jesus out at all. There's no freak out at all. Oh, the whole universe has just disappeared. Fine, it's no freak out. Where can it go? Where can anything go? Wherever anything goes, it's always exactly where it's always been. Doesn't matter, nothing disappears. Everything is still always where it's exactly always been. Nothing has changed. So, you get these people who are orchestrating these emotional reactions, and then, you know, claiming, you see the old movies, the senorita, you know, she's hysteria, they're fanning her off, and then when the person leaves, she doesn't like or something, she kind of opens her eyes and says, oh, gone? Oh, okay, I'm okay, don't worry, I'm okay now. It was all an act, but they get, the actresses and actors are so good, they can get the physiology working for them. So it seems like, wow, it's a fit, it's a fit, it's a fit, oh my gosh. They're very, you know, intense actors and actresses. And you have those people now, so many, so many, 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 many. You know, social media is full of these, freak out, freaking out, you said, what, I'm completely freaked out. I mean, I just can't believe I can't even function, you know, right? Okay, you get the idea, it seems funny, it seems entertaining to look at these actors and actresses, but there's a very, very sinister purpose behind it all. Extremely sinister purpose is you, us, have to disappear because they can't tolerate us, is what the message is. And they got the leverage now through the technology, you see. Absolutely. It's the old thing about the technology and you know, the comic books, like the evil villain gets control of all the technology and they're going to destroy everyone if their demands aren't met. Say, I don't like there to be, you know, pistachio ice cream in the ice cream stores. There's some exotic demand. You must remove all pistachio ice cream from all ice cream stores. This bothers me. And the commissioner say, okay, everybody get rid of the pistachio ice cream. Then I have another demand, you know. I hate chocolate ice cream too. Get rid of chocolate ice cream. Okay, chocolate ice cream's gone. I hate banana ice cream. Get rid of all banana ice cream, you know. More and more demands, you know. I only want there to be coffee ice cream. And all ice cream has to be coffee ice cream. Okay. Just don't press the buttons. Okay. Coffee ice cream everywhere. You know, this is showing us. The comic book showed us what's going to happen, actually. A lot of the comic books were written by people who already know this stuff, and they know what's happened in other places in the big, all this vastness of allness. They know what the scam is, the technology scam, is you get everything hooked up to one button, so to speak, and then you get the bad guy, bad gal in charge of that button, and then they start making demands, right? Only coffee ice cream everywhere. And now you must put this in the drinking water. You must put these additives in all the drinking water. That's my next demand. And so they keep making more and more demands. If you don't do this, I'm going to press the button. Hello, we're already there. We have all these zany, freaky reactants all over the place. Reactors. And, you know, we're going to boycott. We're not going to play our games. We refuse to show up. You don't fire this person. None of us are playing. You know, throwing chaos into, you know, structured financial things. There's complete chaos. See, we don't like what you're doing. We're boycotting. We're not going to do. You know, on and on. You got to fire this person. You got to get rid of this. We're all getting used to this. Leverage is being used now. The social media is using leverage to demand. This has been going on for a long time. You know, there's lots of groups that have been using this type of tactic to say, we're going to completely ruin your brand if you don't do exactly what we tell you to do. It's economic terrorism, really, is what's been happening for a long time. We're going to destroy your brand through social media and the media and all our affiliates who are able to push this in the public consciousness if you don't buckle to our demands. You know, you have to have this in the workplace, that in the workplace. Everybody has to say these words and that words. Everybody has to have these political outlooks, these social, everyone has to agree to our social values. Otherwise, we're going to ruin your brand. And they can. And so the companies go, oh my God. Okay, whatever you want. It's okay. Please, don't ruin our brand. This has been going on nonstop. The whole country's like capitulated. And it's all intentional. But that's just the warm-up act. Now the real heavy stuff is coming. Welcome to the apocalypse. Yes, it's wonderful, because Jesus saves today, right? They cannot intimidate Jesus that way. They cannot. They say, Jesus, we're going to ruin your brand if you don't do what we say. And Jesus says, you can't ruin my brand. It's unruinable. And again, it's all directed towards accepting processing as God, the God of processing. All this stuff, the social movement, social media, all this, these activism, you know, all this stuff that's been so rancid, incredibly rancid in the world for so long now. It's been going on for quite some time, most of my entire life, actually. Severe activism, putting the pressure on many, many things, cutting down all these institutions, etc., that are devoted towards process freeness, you know. This has been going on for so long that it's, you know, it's built up to this incredible, it's ready for this incredible crescendo. That we're way further down the road than most people realize. Way further down the road. All of this is designed towards worshiping process. Okay, worshiping process, 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 process. Ultimately machines, processors. We'll see cyborgs is like, worship them, oh, they're superior to us. Look how process oriented they are. Oh my gosh. So all this has been known, Jesus has known this from the very beginning, Holy Spirit's known it from the very beginning. Many traditions have known this is coming. So we all know this is coming. We all know this is here. This is now here. This is here. This is taking place. Jesus saves today. Jesus saves today. Right? Jesus knows those who are oriented towards process freeness are not mentally ill. They're not suffering from some illness. They're actually accepting reality as it is. They're not trying to turn their back on reality. They're not trying to change reality. They're not trying to separate from reality. They're evaporating their continuity fear, and this is what it's all about. So of course Jesus supports that. We'll see what kind of support he will bring, and we'll find out very soon. All right, very great. That's it for this one.